Well, it's time again for Cooking with Kyle, and I guarantee you, you have never seen an apple pie like this. That's right. Take a close look. Bacon and cheese on top of it. Now, he's going to show us how to make this incredible, delicious delight that your family will gobble up. I've never heard of bacon on apple pie.
Well, and it really, you think about apple and sharp cheddar go well together.
Yeah.
And bacon and sharp cheddar are amazing.
Yes.
So let's just put them all together.
I love that.
Why not? Yeah, people love bacon on everything. It's really very easy. So yeah. let's just get started and do
it. Okay.
Okay, we're going to take our 3/4 cup of firmly packed light brown sugar.
Okay.
Put it in a bowl. And I will mention I'm using specifically Granny Smith apples. That's a personal preference. I like the tartness of it.
Yes.
Okay. Makes it a little bit.
People sometimes don't understand that different apples have different tastes.
They do have different tastes. But I mean, honestly, I'm saying Granny Smith simply because I like the idea of, in addition to my cheddar cheese, I might top this with rum raisin or maybe a little vanilla ice cream. The other thing that's the warning, fair warning, is that when it first comes out of the oven, it has to sit for about an hour before you can cut it.
Okay.
But it's going to make the house smell fantastic.
We
need that around here.
Yes, we do.
Little cinnamon's going in. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is basically apple pie, a little bit of allspice, clove, nutmeg. And then we're also adding just a hint of cornstarch to kind of thicken our gooey inside.
All right.
Now, before we add the apples, and you can see this is just, I've made a big creation mess. Yes, of all the dry ingredients, just kind of sift them together.
Mm-hmm.
You can use your fingers.
That cinnamon smells good.
Well, and the idea behind using a big bowl is because the next thing we're going to do is go ahead and dump those in there.
I can do that.
And we need to thoroughly coat our apples.
I don't have gloves.
Close.
You do.
There we go. And this is just kind of therapeutic for me. Kind of making a toss them in apple salad into our sugar and spice.
And everything nice.
Now, on the pie dough.
Yes.
Of course, you can make your own. You can cheat.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. I'm not going to tell anyone if you cheat. but reality of it is a single layer crust because the top crust, obviously, is our bacon.
Okay. I don't want to get ahead of things, but do you fry the bacon before you put
it on? Nope. I'm going to show you.
Okay.
So we're going to take this and put it in our pie shell.
Mm-mm.
And, of course, this will reduce down a little bit in the cooking process. I will also say this, due to the nature of the sauce in the center,
yes,
probably not a bad idea to place this baby on a cookie sheet.
Okay.
Okay, and it's going to go into a 350-degree oven. Now, this is our lattice. And what we'll do...
And that's just regular uncooked bacon.
It is uncooked bacon. And you'll make the lattice pattern, which is, you know, the over-under.
Uh-huh.
Now, as we do this... What will end up happening is we're going to trim the edges and crimp. I don't know that we'll have time to really trim and crimp, but you can kind of get the idea here. And this is just like, think of a cherry pie or an apple pie with a lattice topping.
Okay.
Nothing wrong with that now, is there?
No, there's not.
No.
And then the heat of the pie is going to cook the bacon?
We will cover this lightly with foil.
Ah, okay.
It will cook for about an hour at 350. Then we'll pull the foil off to kind of... brown it, crisp it just a little bit, but also bear in mind we don't want it super duper crisp from the standpoint that we want it to be able to cut when it comes time to serve the pie.
Oh my gosh, and that just looks wonderful.
Finished product.
Can't wait to taste it. It's going to be great. And of course, if you're new to watching this segment, you know that the recipe is already on our website, KFOR.com/cooking. We have got all of his great recipes from way back when. Thank you so much. This looks good.
Always a pleasure.
Can't wait to taste it.